بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على المبعوث رحمة للعالمين سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. My dear respected brothers and sisters, now إن شاء الله we'll start Quran and Tajweed class. Today you will recite the آيات سورة الشعراء from آية 84 until آية 111. As usual, الحمد لله, we recite the آيات together and then I recite myself, then talking about the meaning of the آيات and then تجويد rules. Okay. So let's start إن شاء الله. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. واجعل لي لسان صدق في الآخرين. واجعل لي لسان صدق في الآخرين. واجعلني من ورثة جنة النعيم. واجعلني من ورثة جنة النعيم. واغفر لأبي إنه كان من الضالين. واغفر لأبي إنه كان من الضالين. If you take care about Gunnah, then everyone will be equal. But when we recite, some brothers take care about Gunna, alhamdulillah, some brothers not. This makes like some troubles. So try to make care, to take, give care for Gunna. واغفر لأبي إنه كان من الضالين. إنه كان من ما شاء الله. ولا تخزني يوم يبعثون. ولا تخزني يوم يبعثون. يوم لا ينفع مال ولا بنون. يوم لا ينفع مال ولا بنون. إلا من أتى الله بقلب سليم. إِلَّا مَنْ أَتَى اللَّهَ بِقَلْبٍ سَلِيمٍ. وأزلفت الجنة للمتقين وأزلفت الجنة للمتقين وبرزت الجحيم للغاوين وبرزت الجحيم للغاوين وقيل لهم أين ما كنتم تعبدون وقيل لهم أين ما كنتم تعبدون من دون الله من دون الله هل ينصرونكم أو ينتصرون هل ينصرونكم أو ينتصرون فكبكبوا فيها هم والغاوون فكبكبوا فيها هم والغاوون وجنود إبليس أجمعون وجنود إبليس أجمعون قالوا وهم فيها يختصمون قالوا وهم فيها يختصمون تالله إن كنا لفي ضلال مبين تالله إن كنا لفي ضلال مبين إذ نسويكم برب العالمين إذ نسويكم برب العالمين وما أضلنا إلا المجرمون وما أضلنا إلا المجرمون فما لنا من شافعين فما لنا من شافعين ولا صديق حميم، ولا صديق حميم. فلو أن لنا كرة فنكون من المؤمنين. فلو أن لنا كرة فنكون من المؤمنين. إن في ذلك لآية، إن في ذلك لآية، وما كان أكثرهم مؤمنين. وَمَا كَانَ أَكْثَرُهُم مُؤْمِنِينَ. وَإِنَّ رَبَّكَ لَهُوَ الْعَزِيزُ الرَّحِيمُ. وَإِنَّ رَبَّكَ لَهُوَ الْعَزِيزُ الرَّحِيمُ. كَذَّبَتْ قَوْمُ نُوحٍ الْمُرْسَلِينَ. كذبت قوم نوح المرسلين. إذ قال لهم أخوهم نوح ألا تتقون. إذ قال لهم أخوهم نوح ألا تتقون. إني لكم رسول أمين. إني لكم رسول أمين. فاتقوا الله وأطيعون. فاتقوا الله وأطيعون. وما أسألكم عليه من أجر. وما أسألكم عليه من أجر. إن أجري إلا على رب العالمين. إن أجري إلا على رب العالمين. فاتقوا الله وأطيعون. فاتقوا الله وأطيعون. قالوا أنؤمن لك واتبعك الأرذلون. قالوا أنؤمن لك واتبعك الأرذلون. بارك الله فيكم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. واجعل لي لسان صدق في الآخرين واجعلني من ورثة جنة النعيم واغفر لأبي إنه كان من الضالين ولا تخزني يوم يبعثون يوم لا ينفع مال ولا بنون إلا من أتى الله بقلب سليم وأزلفت الجنة للمتقين وبرزت الجحيم للغاوين وقيل لهم أين ما كنتم تعبدون من دون الله هل ينصرونكم أو ينتصرون فكبكبوا فيها هم والغاوون وجنود إبليس أجمعون قالوا وهم فيها يختصمون فالله إن كنا لفي ضلال مبين إذ نسويكم برب العالمين وما أضلنا إلا المجرمون فما لنا من شافعين ولا صديق حميم فلو أن لنا كرة فنكون من المؤمنين إن في ذلك لآية وما كان أكثرهم مؤمنين وإن ربك لهو العزيز الرحيم كذبت قوم نوح المرسلين إذ قال لهم أخوهم نوح ألا تتقون إني لكم رسول أمين فاتقوا الله وأطيعون وما أسألكم عليه من أجر إن أجري إلا على رب العالمين فاتقوا الله وأطيعون قالوا أنؤمن لك واتبعك الأرذلون والحمد لله we continue studying سورة الشعراء and the ayat which we recited today it's the continuation of the prophet Ibrahim عليه السلام in the last page started the story of Ibrahim عليه السلام واتلو عليهم نبأ إبراهيم from ayah 69 Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said tell them about the story of Ibrahim alayhi salam and then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the previous ayat about Ibrahim alayhi salam when he called his people to think about what they are worshipping those idols they cannot hear you they cannot answer you. They cannot benefit you. They cannot harm you. Okay. The ayat of today from ayah 84, Ibrahim alayhi salam. The ayah 83. The ayah 83, Ibrahim alayhi salam made dua, Rabbi habli hukman wa alhiqni bis salihin. Ya Allah, give me wisdom and make me among the righteous people. The ayah of today, the first ayah, waj'al li lisana sidqin fil akhirin. Ij'al li lisana sidqin fil akhirin means to make my message and my da'wah continue until the last, until the end. And as you know, the da'wah of our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, it's continuation of Ibrahim alayhi salam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَأَوْحَيْنَا إِلَيْكَ أَنِ اتَّبِعْ مِلَّةَ إِبْرَاهِيمَ حَنِيفًا وَمَا كَانَ مِنَ الْمُشْرِكِينَ. We ordered you to follow the way of Ibrahim alayhi salam. And subhanallah, when one person came to Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم and said to him, يا خير البرية, يا خير البرية, خير البرية, we can find in سورة البينة, سورة البينة, أولئك هم خير البرية. خير البرية means the best of people. خير البرية, البرية means human kind. Okay.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. I just want to remind everyone in the mosque that during the lecture, during the Quran class, please be more calm, especially for the parents, please to condition their children so the other people will be comfortable in joining the class. We will really hope all the parents to control their children, both the father and the mother. Jazakallah khairan.
So when a person said to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, you are the best of mankind, what was the answer of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam? What he said to him? He said, not me. It's not me. This is Ibrahim alayhi salam. خير البرية, the best of people is Ibrahim alayhi salam. Of course, this from the best characters of our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, because he is the best. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam is the best of the sons of Adam. But when he said that, it's out of humbleness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Okay. So Ibrahim alayhi salam in the ayat, waj'alni min warathati jannatin na'im. Ya Allah, make me among the people who will go to jannatin na'im. Waghfir li abi, forgive my father. إِنَّهُ كَانَ مِنَ الضَّالِّينَ. He was among the misguided people. Actually, here we have to stop in this ayah. Ibrahim alayhi salam, he promised his father that he will make dua, will pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive him. After he had some conversation with his father, after he calling him to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and the father refused. And the father at the end said, if you don't stop, I will stone you until death. I will kill you by stone. At that time, Ibrahim عليه السلام said, سلام عليك. سلام. Peace. I will leave. سأستغفر لك ربي. I will ask Allah سبحانه وتعالى to forgive you. Okay? But in Al-Quran, another place, Allah سبحانه وتعالى said, وما كان استغفار إبراهيم لأبيه إلا عن موعدة وعدها إياه فلما تبين له أنه عدو لله تبرأ منه. The meaning, إبراهيم عليه السلام when he made the dua for his father, it was because he promised him. He promised his father to make dua for him. Okay? Then later when Ibrahim discovered there is no way for his father to be mu'min, at that time he said, no, I cannot do any dua for you. He stopped. This ayah actually came among some ayat of Al-Quran Al-Kareem which forbid the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم to make dua for a person who passed away as a non-believer. Like for example, his uncle Abu Talib. Abu Talib, the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, he loved his uncle Abu Talib very much. And until the end, he was trying his best to guide his uncle Abu Talib to Islam. Where at the time of death, he said, my uncle, say la ilaha illallah. So I can ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive you. I can make intercession for you. But at the same time, Abu Jahl and the other leaders of Quraysh said, oh Abu Talib, do you deny the religion of Abdul Muttalib, your father? Then Abu Talib unfortunately said, I choose my father's religion, Abu Abdul Muttalib, and he passed away as a non-believer. So the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said in the hadith in Sahih Muslim, he said, the lowest person punished in Jahannam will be my uncle Abu Talib. He will be the lowest person punished in Jahannam. Allah will put two balls under his feet in Jahannam. And these two balls making his brain boiling. And he will be the lowest person punished in Jahannam. He will think he is the highest person punished in Jahannam, but he is the lowest one. Okay? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned that in Al-Quran. He said, وَلَا تُصَلِّ عَلَىٰ أَحَدٍ مِّنْهُمْ مَاتَ أَبَدًا وَلَا تَقُمْ عَلَىٰ قَبْرِهِ. Don't make salat. Salat here means dua. Because the Arabic word salat, now we use it salat like salat. But the original meaning dua. So here in this ayah, Allah said, وَلَا تُصَلِّ. Don't make salat. Don't make dua for anyone of them passed away. And don't visit his grave. Don't go for his janazah. And after that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala explained about Ibrahim alayhi salam. I said, Ibrahim, he promised his father to make dua for forgiveness. But then when he became sure that the father will be misguided. أعوذ بالله. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala misguides someone and following his desires, whatever he see the signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he will never believe. Because his niyyah is not pure for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows the niyyah. The niyyah of every one of us. The one who is, his niyyah is to increase his iman. His niyyah is to get the knowledge of Islam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give him what he wants. But when the niyyah is not pure, when the niyyah is not clean, then you will get according to your niyyah. You have to be very careful about your niyyah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows what is inside the hearts of the people. Then the next ayah, وَلَا تُخْزِنِي يَوْمَ يُبْعَثُونَ. Ya Allah, don't make me in the day of resurrection, like the one who did some mistake or some crime. So he want to hide himself from the other people. Okay? So the meaning here, Ya Allah, don't disclose me in front of the people in the day of judgment. يَوْمَ لَا يَنْفَعُ مَالٌ وَلَا بَنُونَ. On that day, the money or the sons or the family not benefiting you. Okay? إِلَّا مَنْ أَتَى اللَّهَ بِقَلْبٍ سَلِيمٍ. Except the one who came with pure heart to Allah. قلب سليم. قلب heart. سليم means pure. This is the reason I always repeating my words. Try to purify your heart. It's very important. Very important in Islam to make your heart purified. Otherwise, أعوذ بالله misguidance. You will be misguided. وأزلفت الجنة للمتقين. The Jannah will be given to the متقين, the people who fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And in the other side, the Jahim, the Jahannam will be given to the misguided people. وَقِيلَ لَهُمْ أَيْنَمَا كُنْتُمْ تَعْبُدُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will ask the people of Jahannam, where are the things you used to worship during your lifetimes? Of course, nothing will benefit. And even in Surah Al-Baqarah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, إِذْ تَبَرَّأَ الَّذِينَ اتُّبِعُوا مِنَ الَّذِينَ اتَّبَعُوا وَرَأَوُوا الْعَذَابَ وَتَقَطَّعَتْ بِهِمُ الْأَسْبَابِ. Means the people, like before Islam, they used to worship idols. The idols in the day of judgment, they will say, Ya Allah, we are free of them. We never ask them to worship us. وَجُنُودُ إِبْلِيسَ أَجْمَعُونَ. Also, we'll go to Jahannam. The soldiers of Iblis. Soldiers of Iblis. They will go to Jahannam. Okay? Who are the soldiers of Iblis? Anyone making Iblis, guiding him or leading him. These are the junud of Iblis. And junud of Iblis, not only from jinn, also from people. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, shayateen al-ins wal-jinn. There are shayateen among the ins, mean the humans, and among the jinn. You can find someone, he is shaitan, wal'a'adhu billah, misguiding people. Misguiding people. Okay. قالوا وهم فيها يختصمون. Those people of Jahannam, wal'a'adhu billah, inside Jahannam, they will argue with one another and saying, Allahi means by Allah, by Allah. إن كنا لفي ضلال مبين. We were in very misguided way. To equal you with Allah رب العالمين. وما أضلنا إلا المجرمون. The مجرمون, the criminals, or we can say the wrongdoers, people who misguided us. But actually, this excuse will not be accepted by Allah in the day of judgment, to say, Ya Allah, I was in the wrong way because there is someone misguiding me. This not accepted. Why? Because Allah gave you mind. Allah gave you mind to think. Not anyone inviting you for something, you go. No, you have minds. You have to think. This is right or wrong. And usually wrong is very clear. Wrong is very clear. For the people who having a pure heart. If you have pure heart, you see right is right, wrong is wrong. If the heart is not pure, you will confuse. Sometimes you see wrong is right and see right is wrong. Because the heart, wal'a'adhu billah, is not clean, not pure. فما لنا من شافعين. We don't have intercessors. ولا صديق حميم. And not close friends. Even the friends at the time on judgment, the day of judgment, the best friends who are not making or building their friendship for the sake of Allah, they will be enemies. الأخلاء يومئذ بعضهم لبعض عدو. الأخلاء means the best friends. They will be enemies to each others except المتقين. إلا المتقين. فلو أن لنا كرة فنكون من المؤمنين. They will say, if we have another chance to go back to the dunya again and then to correct ourselves. But of course, impossible. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said the two ayat which repeating from the beginning of the surah. These two ayat you will find after each story. إن في ذلك لآية وما كان أكثرهم مؤمنين وإن ربك لهو العزيز الرحيم. You'll find these two ayat always repeating after each story. Then the next story, نوح. كذبت قوم نوح المرسلين. The people of نوح, they also denied the دعوة of نوح عليه السلام when he called them to توحيد. And they said the last ayah, قالوا أنؤمن لك. Do you want us to believe with you while your followers are low level people, means very poor people. They said, we are in the high rank people, so how come to be with this low level people with you? Okay, inshallah. So now we go to the tajweed rules, inshallah. Waj'al li qalqalah, barakallahu fikum, jim, قلقلة. واجعل لي لسان صدق قلقلة. Also for دال. And we have تنوين after تنوين فاء إخفاء حقيقي. صدق في الآخر. واجعلني قلقلة. بارك الله فيك. Also before إضغام. Huh? There is another thing. The lamb of واجعلني. This lamb, yes. This lamb, we make إظهار. واجعلني. Okay? Because some people, even among the Arab people, can do mistake. Can say واجعلني. Yes, easy to do this mistake. So that's why here, this one, we say إظهار. واجعلني من ورثتي. إضغام with غنة. جنتي. غنة النعيم. غنة. واغفر لأبي إنه. أبي إنه. مد جائز منفصل. We make it two or four حركات. Then we have غنة. إنه كان من الضالين. مد لازم. مد لازم سكس حركات. ولا تخزني يوم يبعثون. قلقلة. يوم لا ينفع. إخفاء حقيقي. مال ولا. إضغام وذغنة. إلا من أتى. إظهار حلقي. نون همزة. إظهار حلقي. من أتى الله بقلب سليم. إخفاء حقيقي. وأزلفت الجنة. غنة للمتقين. وبرزت الجحيم للغاوين. وقيل لهم أينما كنتم. إخفاء حقيقي. تعبدون من دون. إخفاء حقيقي also. دون الله. هل ينصرونكم. إخفاء حقيقي again. أو ينتصرون. إخفاء حقيقي again. So we have in this ayah 1, 2, 3. إخفاء حقيقي. فكبكبوا قلقلة. باء. فيها هم والغاوون. وجنود إبليس. قلقلة. أجمعون. قلقلة again. قالوا وهم فيها يختصمون. تالله إن كنا. إن فرست إخفاء حقيقي. غنا لفي ضلال مبين. إضغام وذغنة. إذ نسويكم برب. What this. إخفاء شفوي. بارك الله فيك. رب العالمين. وما أضلنا. مد جائز منفصل. Two or four حركات. Also another مد جائز منفصل. أضلنا إلا. المجرمون. قلقلة. فما لنا من شافعين. إخفاء حقيقي. ولا صديق حميم. إظهار حلقي. فلو أن لنا غنة كرة فنكون. إخفاء حقيقي. من المؤمنين. إن في غنة. في ذلك لآية. If we continue لآية وإضغام وذغنة. وما كان أكثرهم مؤمنين. أكثرهم مؤمنين. إضغام مثلين. وإن ربك غنة. لهو العزيز الرحيم. كذبت قوم نوح المرسلين. إذ قال لهم be careful not to make a call for them. قال لهم أخوهم نوح ألا. نوح ألا. إظهار حلقي. إني قلنا لكم رسول أمين. إظهار حلقي. فاتقوا الله وأطيعون. وما أسألكم. مد جائز منفصل. تو أور فور حركات. عليه من أجر. إظهار حلقي. أن دين قلقلة. إن أجري. إظهار حلقي. أن دين قلقلة. إن أجري إلا على رب العالمين. فاتقوا الله وأطيعون. قالوا أنؤمن. مد جائز منفصل. تو أور فور حركات. أنؤمن لك واتبعك الأرذلون. والحمد لله. We finished the آيات of today. And إن شاء الله from next week we'll recite the next page from آية 112 until آية 136 إن شاء الله. نوح نيل. يس. بيكوز ذا همزه الوصل. همزه الوصل ان بتوين. اوكي. همزه الوصل. يو نو همزه الوصل. ها ذا الف. ذا الف. ذا فيرست الف. وسي همزه الوصل. اوكي. همزة الوصل exist. Okay. But we don't pronounce it because it's coming in the middle. Okay. So now directly will be after تنوين. Which letter in pronunciation? Lam. I mean when we pronounce, okay, the alif will be dropped, okay, but this alif, even we dropped it, but is still having the thing which separating between the two words. For example, if I make the tanween with lam and make idgham without ghunna, okay, normal we do like this, but here because of the alif al-wasl, even it's now dropped but still having the power to separate between the two words. That's why you say nuhinil, nuhinil. Okay. Yes. الله. ده آية 97. الله. Okay. What is the meaning of الله؟ والله. Same. والله. So sometimes say والله, الله, بالله. Also all having the same meaning. It's swearing by Allah سبحانه وتعالى. Any other questions, inshallah, brothers? Online also, if someone wants to ask, please, you can. If not, we go to the hadith. So today, inshallah, we read one hadith of this chapter. المحافظة على الأعمال. So the meaning of this chapter, the continuation of doing the good deeds, to be regular in doing the good deeds. Okay. As usual, Imam An-Nawawi rahimahullah, he started by some ayat of Al-Quran al-Kareem. Like here he started by ayah 16 of Surah Al-Hadid. And then ayah 27 also Surah Al-Hadid. Then Surah Al-Nahl 92. Surah Al-Hijr 99. All the ayat actually having the same meaning, continuation of doing the good deeds. Now we will go to the hadith. As we said before, we just read one hadith, but there are actually many other ahadith, but we just take one hadith. The first hadith in this chapter, عن عمر بن الخطاب رضي الله عنه قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم من نام عن حزبه من الليل أو عن شيء منه فقرأه ما بين صلاة الفجر وصلاة الظهر كتب له كأنما قرأه من الليل. رواه مسلم. So the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said in this hadith of عمر بن الخطاب, whoever sleeps without reciting the regular recitation he used to do in the night. Okay. So a person his way is to recite some ayat night time. This is habit. Or to pray tahajjud. But one time he slept. He didn't do. Then in the next day he did it between Fajr and Dhuhr. I used to recite some ayat of Al-Quran every night. But one night I slept. In the next day I recited what I missed last night between Fajr and Dhuhr. Okay, so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give him the reward, the thawab, as if he recited it in the night. Maybe some people will say, what is the difference? I already recited it. Same. No. To recite it in the night time, the reward will be high, because the time of tahajjud, when the people sleeping, but you are waking up and reciting some part of Al-Quran al-Kareem. So the thawab will be high, not the same thawab you can get if you read it in the daytime. You will get thawab, of course, but not in the same level. But here, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows that this person always taking care about his habit. My habit, I always read. But sometimes, out of control, I slept, I couldn't. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because your niyyah is pure, and your niyyah is to do it regularly, Allah will give you the same reward, because Allah knows your niyyah. We always say niyyah in Islam. Niyyah in Islam very important. The heart is very important in Islam. Take care of your heart. So here, this hadith given us a lesson that when you are doing things regularly, good deeds, and in sometimes you miss it, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward you in full, because you are doing it regularly. Okay. We have a similar, even the hadith is not written here, but we have another hadith giving like the same meaning. This hadith said, whoever getting sick or traveling, these two things, a person getting sick or traveling, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give him the same reward when he used to do the deeds when he was healthy and residence. And as you know, alhamdulillah, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala always keep our health in good condition. When a person healthy, mashallah, he can do a lot of ibadat. But when a person getting sick, the ibadat will be less. When a person traveling, the ibadat will be less. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because his intention always to do the ibadat regularly, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give him the full thawab as when he was healthy, when he was residence, because of his good name. That's why brothers always advise, try to make good niyyah for many things good to do. If you can do, alhamdulillah. If you can't do, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by his generosity will reward you just because of niyya. Just because of your niyya. It said that one prophet of Bani Israel, during his time, it was a very huge famine. There is no food, and people die because no food. And at the time, one person was passing near to one mountain. Then he made niyyah. Ya Allah, if I have like this mountain food, I will give it sadaqah to the people. Just niyyah. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent Jibreel alayhi salam to the prophet at that time to go to that man. So the prophet knocked his door of that man and said, I am the messenger of Allah to you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepted your sadaqah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave you the sadaqah as if you spend like this mountain food because of the pure niyyah. So always try to make your niyyah in your heart and be sure that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you the reward for that. Okay? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows what is inside the hearts of the people.